Hi everyone, welcome to Trading in Zone. So on this weekly review episode, we will quickly talk about what the tower talks are and what's the news which is in store for the coming week. And the stocks which are in news, it's a result season, so a lot of stocks are in news obviously because of the results they are posting, and they're doing pretty good post their results. So let's quickly look at some of the stocks and how they are doing. First one is obviously we'll look at Yes Bank. Bad results, stock has gone down significantly, and then there is a slight retrace. So definitely wait and watch. Different people have provided different kinds of views from their perspective in terms of whether the stock is going to further go down to 120, 130, or whether the stock is going to reverse and rebound from here. Let's understand one thing. It is just that the provisions have increased, so they have just kept more money from a business perspective in terms of covering the previous losses what they've made. That doesn't necessarily mean that the same losses are going to repeat, and there is a significant correction that's already happened on the stock. So we need to wait and watch before we really decide on the stock. From an investor perspective, if you are looking at a 3 or 4 year kind of horizon, every large dip gives a great opportunity to buy. I'm sure this is going to be a revival story for the Mumbai based bank. The second one is Godrej Properties. They are planning to develop quite a few properties in the next 1 year or so. The future looks pretty bright, and it's also part of the Tower Talk news, so I would definitely recommend to have a look at that stock and look at buying. Reliance Communication, obviously stay out. NLCT, it is definitely going to go for a bid. I'm really not sure which company is going to come and bid for this particular company, but if you are a risk taker, you can probably buy and keep some stock. Someone buys this company tomorrow, you might get some exponential growth, or you might get a 20-30% kind of a return. For me personally, from a defensive investor background, the background I come from, I would definitely suggest not to buy this. But yes, in the Tower Talk news, it is a recommendation as a buy, but I wouldn't recommend myself. DCM Shriram is a very good stock. What I'm seeing is that their EPS has significantly increased from almost about 4 rupees to 18 rupees, which is a significant increase. And obviously, this stock will grow multifold. For a stock at a earning per share to significantly improve from 4 to 18 in a quarter or so is a significant amount of growth. So this is definitely a blind buy for anyone who's looking at investing from a result perspective. If you want to watch them technically, you can obviously watch the chart and you can look at the support and resistance, and you can buy at an appropriate level as an investor as well. Shares of Wadia Group, especially the Bombay Dyeing Group, kind of fell down on the news of Wadia being arrested, which came through. So some of these stocks might bounce back up. So it's definitely a watch for the coming week. It's not a great impact, him being arrested, for the company as such, but you can look at a contrary trade right over here and see if it's gonna move up. It is definitely a good buy. Lupin, there are two news. There is one news that there is some drug recall and there are a lot of issues on Lupin, and then the other news is that Lupin has received US FDA approval for Boston tablets. It's a pulmonary arterial hypertension tablet. So obviously it's a blood pressure tablet. It's a positive for the company because some of these are very common ailments and might increase their revenue, but there are contradicting news. So it's a wait and watch from my perspective. So let's see if it's gonna make any difference or not, because there is a positive news and there is also a negative news. Edelweiss has downgraded Bank of Baroda because it's also combined with Vijaya Bank and Dina Bank. These two banks are not really doing that great from their balance sheet perspective, so it's probably got downgraded. The other bank which is also on radar is obviously Punjab National Bank. It is pretty steady, and it's also looking pretty attractive from a buy perspective. So continue to watch. PNB can become a good buy. Britannia posted pretty decent results, 14% profit after tax for Q4, and quite a few new launches as well in their pipeline. But and also I did share with my trainee groups the levels to buy on Britannia, and it is probably a stock which is kind of wait and watch at this point in time for a good reversal. But if you're accumulating in small quantities, you can, because they have done pretty well. And wait for the elections to kind of settle down, because right now market is swinging up and down. We really don't know what levels the market is going to sustain or how it's gonna move. Euromoto is obviously was doing pretty well. Vikram, one of our channel members, was suggesting Hiromoto as a buy, and it did give a good decent move. And what I see is that from a news perspective, they're doing a lot of investment on marketing, and they're placing themselves as competitive against Royal Enfield. So it can be a good move in the coming future, given the fight which they're putting up and given the amount of money what they're trying to spend. It can become a very good move in the coming days. So Hero Motor is definitely a watch. So apart from these stocks, you know, there is a lot of market news which was happening for quite some time. So it's definitely some of these stocks we can look at, review, and kind of keep them on our radar in terms of a buy. Kotak Mahindra Bank did pretty well from the result perspective. If you look at longer period of time, I would definitely advise you to buy Kotak on every dip, because they're doing fantastic job. It's going non-stop. I was recommending this stock on an intraday basis, and I saw this move 20-30 rupees within a single day. So day traders, bliss. They would have made significant amount of money if they have seen the way Kotak is moving. I would, from an investor perspective, I would obviously want to buy Kotak Bank at every dip. It is not something which is on my portfolio, to be honest, at this point in time, because Titan is a stock which I'm holding from a very long period of time. I'm expecting more move on Titan in the coming weeks as well, because Titan is going to probably post a good result. I'm making a separate video on Titan. I hope you're going to enjoy that as well. But Kotak is definitely a buy. HDFC Life Insurance, you know, dipped down. One of the companies kind of selling their stock and all that stuff, the life insurance part of it, the HDFC Life, because it's a combined company. But you can definitely look at buying HDFC over a period of time for you to see how it's gonna move up. Alright, some of the other stocks which saw some amount of movement while closing on Friday, which were on my radar, I did see Aibul Housing Finance recovering pretty much and closing above the 700 level, which seems to be, you know, a good buy. But DHFL was very significant in its movement, so I would definitely want to keep it on radar from a technical perspective. Probably the stocks which I would want to avoid buying at this point in time, Pidilite is something which I would want to avoid buying, and also Jet Air, I'm trying to keep away from that counter given the kind of volatility. But yeah, there are a lot of contrarian you know, views. The other thing which I've seen is that there is some news on Bharti Airtel. I did read this news, and they are going to list in the London Stock Exchange pretty shortly, and they're going to raise quite a bit of money. And this news was kind of confirmed by Bloomberg. So I would advise you all to look at Airtel on a, you know, weekly basis. It was at a key support. 300 seems to be pretty strong support from a technical view as well. It can be a very good buy for the coming week. So Airtel is definitely something which I would personally want to look at as well, given the kind of news which it has. Some of the other stocks which have been doing pretty well. Also, I did share a stock chart on the Discord server. I think it's a good buy. Bharat Forge is the stock which I was looking at. It has seen a very nice reversal trend. A strong bull candle has formed, and it's right at the support zone as well. So it becomes a very good buy. Maybe a slight retrace downwards one can buy with a very small stop loss. I've mentioned the levels on the Discord channel, so you can definitely watch that. Obviously, I've also mentioned Dhanlakshmi Bank. Dhanlakshmi Bank is a good stock, good story, good revival, going and moving ahead. So I would definitely advise you all to accumulate in small quantities. It might be something which can move a lot more. The other stocks I would continue, you know, from my notes perspective as well, I've made my notes very clear. I am still kind of bullish on HDFC Bank. I'm still kind of bullish on UPL because they're probably going to move a lot more, and I would definitely advise all of you to continue to watch them. Larsen Turbo, maybe at a certain level we might see some volumes coming in. It's a good stock, very strong order book. Been having the stock for pretty long period of time with myself. I would definitely advise all of you to look at L&T for a very long perspective as well. I was also giving an advice on Jindal Steel. Jindal Steel is doing pretty well, and would advise you to look at Jindal Steel as an option. Star is definitely a buy. I'm still looking at it to cross 500 odd, or maybe the target might be around 500 also in the coming week. So definitely a stock which is worth keeping on your buy radar. Now, some of the other stocks which we have looked at, the metal sector is doing pretty well. So continue to watch the metal sector. The sector which kind of tanked, which I expected to move, but it didn't do really well, was obviously one IT. didn't do well. After a slight glimmer of hope of moving up, IT has kind of come down. The second stock which I expected, the second sector rather, which I expected to move strongly was auto. Auto also is consolidating. It significantly dived down. The news in the market is that the auto sector is not going to dish out strong results. So at this point in time, keep accumulating. If you get any significant dips, maybe post September, post Diwali, when the sales come into play, when the revenues are going to increase for some of these auto stocks, they might be a good buy. At this point in time, I'm not really seeing any hope in the auto sector. None of the stocks are really doing that great. Maybe stocks like Madhusumi and stuff like that might do well from, because they're all auto ancillary as a business, but otherwise there is nothing much in the auto sector as well. Pharma sector showed some strength, lot of news and lot of buzz, but some of the stocks kind of retraced. I'm really not sure why Aurofarma retraced after kind of making a breakout. I was expecting them to move up. So it's also kind of the way the investors are looking at, and it looks like most of the big players are kind of staying away from the market because it seems to be more of retail participation at this point in time in the market and not really any of the big investors' participation, because the moment it goes to around 11,800, there is a significant amount of selling which starts, and the moment it comes down to around 11,600, we see buying happening. So until it's in that particular range, we really need to wait and watch what's the direction for Nifty. All right. And even if you see the FII, DII information, I mean, the FII is continuing to buy, but they have just bought about 300 crore in net, which is significantly very low. And also it was a very short trading week, so I wouldn't blame them. But the DII is like minus 4.6 in the total net buy. So they bought about 10,000 crores, but they also sold about 10,000 crores, and they just ended up about minus 4.6 crores, which is on a negative bias. But if you see, DII is around 18,000 crores, but the sell value is around 17,700 crores. So around net 300 crores is where they kept buying. So they're still bullish. Take care, guys. Have a wonderful week ahead. Thanks. Bye.